How do you see the terrorism, especially in Europe, needing to be handled in the near future?
Well, terrorism, it is like it is to our way of thinking, a desperate, desperate cry of helplessness and rage. Terrorism comes about because of the perversion of anger. In this case, our sense is that those who are the perpetrators, they come from a background of believing that they are disvalued, that they are less than. Secondary, something we just talked about when we talked about the political classes in this United States of America and in Europe, the same thing. But this idea of being a second class, or in their case, being considered a third class citizen without access to the resources of their own country. Sometimes those resources seem to be overtaken by the United States or China or large major powers in the world. Where their future feels taken from them. And it's almost a sense of complete, I've tried talking to you, I've tried being nice to you, I've tried trying to negotiate with you, and you ignore me and pretend I'm invisible and I don't matter. And the rage begets rage begets rage until we have no other option. Nothing else works. The only way that anyone ever pays attention is when we blow up, literally blow up. But two things in particular are happening. When this, we would say, this generation of terrorism became, which is well before your 9/11, it's what America's knowledgeable about, but there was terrorism within the Middle Eastern countries themselves and then spreading into India, Pakistan, and other countries that the United States does not track their day-to-day activity in terms of your public news broadcasts. So 9/11 was a knock on the forehead for the American public in terms of, wow, this is happening to other people. But in that, one of the first times that people reacted, if you will, when the dust settled, when the immediate pain and the grief could be somewhat comforted, they became aware that that terrorists were human. And that was the hardest moment in all of that, that terrorists are human beings. They are desperately damaged, desperately seeking reassurance and confirmation of their lovability. They are locked into a fear that if I don't do this, then not even God will see me, not even God will love me, and I am without meaning, and so I'm left with nothing except to demonstrate and prove, faces of fear, my worth to my God by destroying his perceived enemies. And when you lay that against the concept of an unconditionally loving God, you can see where the craziness can come in. But it doesn't matter. As long as they hold the concept in their minds that this terrorism, this striking out against others, is what I do that has value to my God, they're going to continue to do it. One of the things that's happening now, though, through this generation is something that a lot of people in the general public aren't aware of, is that these countries with these terrorists have lost generations of men. The available manpower in these countries has been decimated. And so you see some of their desperate efforts, kidnapping women, attempting to force women into pregnancy so that their children can then become soldiers. And in this, I haven't got so many guys to carry rifles. I guess I can do more damage with one guy with one bomb mentality comes in. And then they also say, okay, well, I don't have to be foolish or stupid to be a terrorist. I can look at these things like computers and I can begin to attack infrastructure. But more than that, with Europe in particular, you're seeing them a shift in their thinking that, you know what, I'm going to start attacking their joy because that's what they have that I do not have. They have joy, they have happiness, they have community in which they engage in loving and giving and song and dance and food and sharing, and the freedom in that is denied me, and I will strike out against that in particular. And this idea of hit and run, yes, it is the penultimate of the bullied child. So many, many faces pointing to more and more desperation in terms of we haven't got as many people as we could have to do this. But the thing that's shifting and that we believe will be one of the ultimate healing steps for the calming and the comforting and the quieting of the terrorism is that the energy of the women of these countries must rise up. It will be the women who say, I won't have one more of my children come home to me dead. I won't have one more of my children sacrificed to war. I won't have another child. I refuse to have another pregnancy because no matter what child I bring into this world, they will be murdered in your war. The women will begin, the female energy will begin to separate itself. And because of the entrenchment in this society of male domination, you begin to see a balance happening where the men's power begins to drop simply because so many are gone. You don't have a 50-50 distribution between masculine and feminine in the population anymore. It's more dropping more along the lines of about 25 to 75% women, 25% men. And so the power of women is slowly, slowly, slowly beginning to roll in terms of weight. It's not okay with me. I shouldn't have to sacrifice every part of my life, every possible opportunity for joy, to satisfy this man's God. So the rising up of the women will be the turning point in this concept of laying to rest terrorism.